Hello, my dear friends. Welcome back to Aspire 32. And today we are starting with another great session of another podcast. And we have Dr. Roxanne Samuel here with us today. So today's topic is way out of any other topic from dentistry. It is something special. And I'm really happy to introduce all of you to Dr. Roxanne, who has personally inspired me to think about branding, and which all of us have very little idea. And most of our viewers, since they are very young, they are into early days of dentistry. This topic will inspire you to think something different from the beginning, because all of us only think about branding when you establish something. And today, Dr. Samuel here to guide us all this required information. So first of all, welcome to the channel, Dr. Roxanne.
Thank you for this wonderful opportunity, sir, and kind introduction.
So let me introduce you to my viewers. He is a dentist. He has a postgraduate diploma in digital marketing, and the list is very big. But personally, I can tell you how I look at Dr. Roxanne is he has been inspiring me. He posts about leadership. He posts about how you can think different, how you can market yourself. And his qualities are immense. And most of you who follow him on his Facebook page, you will realize that his posts are simply amazing. And that's why today I want to know, Dr. Roxanne, that why is that branding is so important?
I'm assuming today that our audience will be the ambitious ones, right? You see, some people think, okay, I think I will graduate and get a job somewhere. Wouldn't have come to watch this video. They'll be waiting for something to come fall in their lap. Believe me, nothing does. But not you guys. You're probably busier than your friends. You know, a degree isn't going to get enough to get a dream career you want. You're watching this because you want to stand out and you're looking for ways to do it right.
So that's very important. You know, as I have been mentioning in many of the podcasts which we have been doing, that we all have degree. And in today's world, Dr. Roxanne has seen that everybody is doing good job. But the way the project also makes an impact, I think that is what is needed. And I really don't know. Maybe there is a two side of it. Some people like it, some people don't like it. So if you can throw a light on these aspects also. But personally, why did you think of starting with a career in branding, you know, helping people with that thought of approach?
Today, I'm going to talk about personal branding because as a person, how are other people's perception about us, what they think about us, and what we really stand for, right? A personal branding is nearly a synonym to your reputation. It is the appearance you display in your life towards the people in it and the impact it has both inside and outside your career. No matter where you see yourself on the personal scale, a student, a job candidate, or an employee, or a business owner, or a freelancer, personal branding is very crucial for you. It includes your skill, your job qualification, your personality, and everything else that makes you, you. Yes, it matters how you dress and speak, but in today's world, it's equally as important to pay attention how you look online.
That's really important, and you have summed up in a very nice way. And of course, it is same as everywhere. As you mentioned, we have the brand surrounding us. If you are buying a toothpaste, we go for Colgate. One is we have a trust, and we also have the brand effect in it. And many times we do value brand a lot, no matter whether you are buying a car, whether you are buying any instrument in dentistry. So my next question for you is, when you say that personal branding, is it your face? You know, when I started my Aspire 32, I started with a small logo without a lot of thought in my mind. Some people project their face in the YouTube channel. Some people project the logo in the YouTube channel. What is exactly branding? Is it important that you should have the logo, or you can take your own face to branding?
Both is possible. Like if you talk about a face, like for example, a celebrity or a politician, they'll be projecting their image, right? As we talk as a brand here, a logo is just a visual representation where you will use the same pictorial form everywhere, wherever you go and whatever you do. it should project your purpose of your life.
Great. I think you have mentioned a very important point, the purpose. So that's what drives you, right? It is more about, it should be in sync with the purpose of your life rather than just having a brand and projecting yourself. Are you saying that?
Yes. Yes, it's what we stand for, what people are looking out for us. We have some followers, right? What followers are expecting from you? The same way, like the people, what they expect from me. So that projection, that is the most important point of this branding.
So if you think of doing a branding, how do you start with it? How do you start? Is it that you simply open a Facebook page or you simply have a YouTube channel? Is the branding restricted to the projection? Is it restricted to only online marketing? As a dentist, if you can give us some information, how exactly one should think going ahead when they think of branding?
So first, we need to know ourselves better.
Yeah.
We should know our strength.
Okay.
We should know our passion. We should know our interest. And yes, we should know our values, and we should find our inspiration. So before starting anything else, these are the, we should know ourselves better, what we love to do, right? So there are a few tools online. Before getting into the branding part, I think these are the most important part. I feel like I'm trying to convey here. One is like Myers-Briggs type indicators. It's a personality trait indicator. You need to find your personality, where you stand. There are introverts, there are extroverts, there are advocates, counselors. Like what type you really are and where you fit in the market. That you need to analyze yourself first. And to analyze your strength, your weakness, your opportunity and press, there is something called SWOT analysis. So these are the basic things you need to start with. So then you can then you need to filter your passion and your interest, right? So once you've done with that, you know where you stand, and you know what are your interests and passions. Then you will get an idea of what you need to start with.
Fine. So you mentioned that you will also be telling us some important steps in branding. So what are the 5 important steps if you want to start with the branding?
Yes, as I said, first get to know yourself better. There are few different ways that can evaluate your own professional persona, both from the inside and how the world perceives you, right? First, learn your strength, okay? Figure out what is that you are good in order to allow yourself to become an effective leader, communicate better, and find personal empowerment. It's more of motivating yourself. No one will push you to do anything, right? We have to motivate ourselves. For motivating ourselves, we should have a purpose. To do so, you can ask 10 people that you know very well. You can ask them, what are the 10 points, ups and downs of me? So you can take the most common answers among those. And as I mentioned before, you can work on the Myers-Briggs type indicator. Then you'll be able to get your strengths. And the next one is finding your passion and interest. Just as important as your strengths are the fulfillment activity in your life. That's because if you do something from your heart, you're more likely to do with motivation and energy, and others will certainly notice it. And the third one is your values. Values are what you stand behind no matter what. These are the things that you don't budge on, right? As they are the most important things to you and that the way you live your life. When your values are positive, people will be more connected to you. And the last one is inspiration. Like, do you have someone that look up to? Like, you'll have a mentor. You admire someone. You should keep following them. Why do you want to learn from them? What do you want to learn from them? While answering all these questions, be genuine and honest with you, who you are, rather than striving for something too far from your personal truth. So these are the important things.
Okay. So I think it is like, you know, for online marketing, or maybe you want to project online, I follow you. You are my role model for projecting all the information. Maybe although I'm very poor with it, the way you project in a very positive way, that inspires many people. And I'm sure that this information is also helpful, what you have shared today. So I wanted to know that you do have a group as Dental Reach. I have seen it personally that from beginning you have been very professional, organized. The logo inspires and the group has a very good coordination. And I have always seen that you guys are doing a lot of good activities in a very professional way, which is sometimes difficult to see in online platform. Because when the organization grows, I'm sure that when you have a brand, people get associated with who are working together in order to improve the brand. If I just want to know, it is my personal question, that how as a team a branding can, do you require a team to grow your brand, or a one person can itself grow the team, grow the brand?
It all starts from a person. It may be the brainchild of someone. It starts from everyone. So one person heart, a dream, right? It starts with a dream. Then you need to find the people you want to associate with. This is the most important thing. You need to trust them, right? And in Dental Reach, we have around 15 dentists from different parts of India. And they all practice in the daytime and work for Dental Reach in the nighttime. It's all passionate people. You need to find the right talent and the purpose, right? We need to find the right purpose and give them the right opportunity to excel in their field. We can't force someone to do something. So it's all like giving opportunity and giving a podium for the people, right?
Very good thought what you have. Working as a team is very important. My next question is it important that you think about branding when you establish something? For example, I start with a dental clinic. Do you think branding should be thought at that moment, or you can start with some other purpose and you have a brand and then maybe you can associate it? Do you think that is a better idea, or it is, how do you go ahead with it? Because students don't have any idea from early days of dental school. Do you think you can help give them some idea regarding what they should think in early days, which that can help them in future when they think about branding?
So let me put in three things. One, as a student. One, as a starting a new clinic where he wants to plan as a branding. And the third thing is already started a practice, but like thinking, okay, something is not working. And there is something called rebranding also. Okay. So as a student, like an undergraduate doing a BDS, so he may be having some aspiration to become a prosthodontist or an endodontist or any other specialty. So he'll be aspiring for that. So he will have some things, right? I'll become an academician, or I'll become a good practitioner, or I'll become an entrepreneur or a businessman. So that vision, towards that, he should start building his social profiles, his online presence, and what are the things are needed for that. Okay, that is the first thing. And the second thing is a dentist who want to start the practice branding. The branding, it's start from the logo, name, tagline, and even the color matters. Each and every color signifies a meaning, right? For example, if you are a general practitioner and your target audience is general public, okay? So you should have a logo and a tagline like caring for your smiles, a family, and something like that. So a blue color. And even the clinic setups and all the marketing activities and can be aligned with that. For example, if you're a prosthodontist and your patients are more like a rehabilitation or rest prosthesis, right? So your target audience are different. There is called patient persona. In the marketing world, we call them buyer persona. So you need to find your personas. Last week I have released a video also on that. So there is a persona for everything. So you should, when you start collecting data of your patients, you will understand what is their pain points and interest. For example, if a patient is like 30 years of age group and he's working in IT, and he likes traveling so much, and plus he likes communicating only through emails. So you got a persona there. So you'll have a set of patients there who only like these kind of activities. So this is a persona, and maybe if you can go to my page, a detailed video is there. You can understand how the patient persona works. So same like that, every specialty has a persona. And the third one is rebranding. Suppose you have a clinic and you feel, okay, you're not getting much exposure or patient or patient flow is slow. So you want to rebrand it. For example, recently the Vodafone and Idea merged to form V. That is called rebranding. Rebranding happens due to several reasons. Maybe the market value, or that there are some bad reputation, converting that to good reputation, creating a new market. So same way, if you want to rebrand your clinic from your old to the new, where you want to explore the new market, so you can try rebranding also for that.
How can you use different social platforms? We have Facebook, we have Insta, we have Twitter, we have LinkedIn. You have so many platforms. How can you use these different social media platforms for branding?
Yes. So first, for this, we need to have our target audience. We should know whom we are marketing. We can't market to anyone, right? We should have our niche market, right? We should find out who is our audience. And now if you take Facebook, the current trend in Facebook is the 30 plus age groups are there in Facebook. The young generations are not there in Facebook. They are all on Instagram and Snapchat. The millennials have the purchasing power now, and they are the next generation of purchasing. They are coming to the next generation now, right? So they will be taking the charge of the family. If you take the millennial age group now, they are like mostly they are going to get married now or maybe having a child. So there are a lot of needs for them. So they are the purchasing power. So they are majorly present in Instagram rather than Facebook. And if you take YouTube, it's more generic, right? And if it one more platform is we can talk as LinkedIn. LinkedIn is more kind of your career based. It's like an online resume with unlimited pages. So you can build your online professional resume there using LinkedIn. You can also connect with directly to the businesses. Your B2B businesses can be done through LinkedIn.
Yeah, when you say that there are multiple platforms like Insta, Facebook. Do you think the post also should be different? Like the way I generally or anybody, we have same, suppose we have one video, or suppose you have a post. Do you post it in the same way in Insta or YouTube community platform or LinkedIn? Or do you think the design also should be different for everyone?
The design part, the way branding comes, where it will align everywhere the same, the color, the logo part. The content might slightly change because the audience are different everywhere. When if someone follows you on YouTube, they will watch you on YouTube. The same person may not watch you on Instagram or Facebook. Everyone has their loyalty towards their social media also. So every audiences are different. So always you should try to pull all your audience to the one point.
If somebody is following you on Insta, somebody is following you on Facebook, and you have a profile in LinkedIn or a Twitter, you want them to, so you are posting something on these platforms, but directing them to your one single platform where it is easier to follow.
Yes. So for example, your majority is YouTube, right? You have 11K followers. So what you can do in other platforms is you can just put a trailer. 1-2 minute video. If you want to watch the full video, come here. So how to create one more idea, how to create a multiple content from a single video. A single video, you can split it into 15 or 20 videos. And you can post it in the range of 2 months. So this is content marketing. So how you plan your content?
Yes. Now, apart from this, you explained us how to think about marketing in a online platform. But when it comes to patient communication, and reaching them, conveying them, how do you think about it?
Yes. When a patient comes to you, first thing what we know that they trust us and they come to us, right? So the trust point is created there. So that from that touch point, how the journey starts. So as soon as they come enter your clinic, you should ask them to like your Facebook page or subscribe to your email newsletter, because we can't force anyone to like or that's in internet. We can't just import an email address and send them. It'll obviously don't work or end up in spam. So this action has to be done from their side only. So once the first touch point only, their experience should be, first impression should be good. And that touch point only, you should be able to collect all their data and you should start marketing them. For example, you can create a WhatsApp broadcast and email. You can, MailChimp is there. It provides free email marketing up to 3,000 contacts. So you can give them the subscription link you will get, so they can subscribe to that. So you can send a weekly newsletter or a monthly newsletter. So they won't forget you. It's not like they come for a single visit and the treatment is done and it's gone. So every month or every 15 days also, you can send a reminder. Okay, this month you should take care of your family. Okay, you should brush twice daily. Okay, this is a condition and this is a solution. So if you keep following up with them, the loyalty increases. And it's more chances also they will recommend you to their friends and families also. So every touchpoint is important.
So it is more about the people remembering you rather than what message, what have you written in email. It is more about that they constantly are reminded about your care for them. The next question would be, it's a community. I have my YouTube channel. My purpose is to educate people. I don't have any, maybe you may have multiple ways of looking at it, but the main purpose is improving their knowledge. But nowadays, it is more about building a community. I want people to interact with me. I want to guide them and sharing with our own experiences, which maybe everybody doesn't have same experience, and we have to agree with it. But there is a very nice quote also that everybody can't make all mistakes. So you have to learn from the mistakes of the others also. And that's what, yes, in my YouTube channel, and the reason for this podcast is I see people in my surrounding area doing so many good things in some specialized field, which we are not good. So it is more about building the community here. What is your thought process in this?
Okay, if you want to relate this to branding, the one point comes to my mind is, it's you, right? So how we are different from others, you have to stand out from the crowd first. We have to be a leader first to...
people can follow you, yes.
Follow you, right?
Yes. Yes.
And I follow 80-20 rule. So 80%, we talk about them. 20%, we talk about us. Whatever we say, it should not be like a sales copy or sales pitch. So if we want others to engage with us, 80%, we have to talk about them and their needs. Because there is something called storytelling, which we learn in this marketing. In the storytelling, we have hero, villain, and a savior. Always the hero of our story is our patient. We are the savior. And villain is, we can say, dental caries, coffee, ice, those are the villains. So you should plan it in a storytelling way. So whatever we do, communicate with them, it should be in a storytelling way. And these are the core thing in the communication.
I think that's very nice point which you have mentioned, Dr. Roxon. And I agree with this fact is, I see that the current generation of students who are in learning in dentistry or any field, they don't talk much to the patient. They look more in the card, what is written, what is the diagnosis. I don't find talking to the patient. And that is the one thing which may be making a larger impact for your practice. And that has been always true, right? It is, as you are saying, that your practice grows because of the word of mouth. That only happens if the patient feels that he feels that we are caring for them. And the people, yes, who are looking, if you are young practitioners who are new in dental school, then I personally request all of you that spend some time with the patient and talk to them. That has major impact. And of course, you have to have a skill. But sometimes if you don't feel the pain of the patient, then it becomes patient doesn't connect with you. And that's a very good point what Dr. Roxon has also mentioned, which helps you with the branding. How do you build online reputation? And we belong to other generation, and there is new generation which is there. And earlier, I was also not much in projecting my work on social media. I had a purpose, but I was a bit reluctant to project it online. And we tend to think that it is not good because you are, maybe there are people who are different and projecting in a different way.
But before coming to this point, I want to mention a few points. I have written an interesting article on selling without selling. It's how to market yourself without marketing yourself. So that is also interesting. And one more article you can find on my LinkedIn. What is the core purpose of neuromarketing? How emotion play roles in marketing? So these two things, if you read, these all the many dots, you need to connect all the dots to find your purpose, right? So these are the dots. And now coming to your question, so online reputation. So online reputation, if you ask, like, first, you should know your target audience. And second, if someone wants to find you, when someone searches your name in a Google, or someone searches their issues, I have tooth pain, so I want to find a dentist in this area. So your name comes up. Okay, then they type your name and they search you. They find your Facebook page. They see your Google reviews. So according to the current trends, 80% of the rejection happens by seeing online reviews. If someone goes searches Dr. Roxanne Samuel on the Google, there should be at least one or two pages of my things. So when they see all the results, they should know what I am and what I do. The transparency should be there. So that creates the first level of trust. The second level of trust, they open it. They see all my content. I talk about oral hygiene. I talk about how to improve your oral dental care. I talk about the many different solutions. So it's like an astrology. When you go to astrologer, when he says something, you know it's written for you. Yes, the same way it happens to patient also. When they open your Facebook page or even your profile or any of your directory listing, when they read it, okay, this doctor, he has written all my problems, so he'll have all my solutions. And the same way, in how many places you repeat yourself. They find you on Facebook, they find you on LinkedIn, they find you on YouTube, they find you on WhatsApp. It's our mindset. We call as brand reminders. We keep reminding them about us. The same way our medical representative does, right? They just come, they show the brand name, prescribe this product. So when we are prescribing a medicine to a patient, what comes to our mind, we write it. The same way when we do for the voting for the election, which name we trust the most, which we heard the most, we trust the most, we tick that name. So how many times we repeat ourselves online? How many times the people recognizes us and see us and the value, the content what we produce and provide them? They find value in that. They recognize us and our reputation increases. And we should always reply to all the negative comments. There will be positive and there will be negative also. But we should always not ignore them. We should reply to them. So this consistency is very important in this.
Okay, Dr. Roxanne, thank you so much for that information. At the end, I want to know which can be the other sites where they can visit, learn more about branding. I know that you can personally coach them and give them an idea, and people should follow you on your Facebook page and all other platforms. Do you recommend them any other websites to think about branding?
Yes, you can find a lot of websites online. One is HubSpot, where you learn about branding to marketing, and the branding journal is there, and 99 Designs, where you get the ideas of your logo, how the clinic design-wise, and all those things you will get. And to find me, you just need to search my name on Google and you will find me.
Yes, Dr. Roxanne is everywhere. And my request for everyone who is watching this podcast is you should follow Dr. Roxanne. You can also join their group Dental Reach, which has been contributing a lot for the betterment of the dentistry. And at the end of this, I want to thank you once again, Dr. Roxanne, for giving your precious time. Thank you so much again for watching this podcast. We'll come with another few more podcasts on Aspire 32 very soon. Bye for now.